going to talk about the solution, how we would solve the equations that we generated for adiabatic semi-batch reactor. In part one, we generate the equations and all the parameters, and we showed the solution output, how the temperature and the number of moles change as a function of time. And so here we want to show the polymath program that was used to generate that solution. So here's the polymath program that I used to generate the solutions for this adiabatic semi-batch reactor. Just a reminder, when we have the number sign, that's a comment in polymath. And so what I've done is indicate the differential equations. That's the mole balance on A, the mole balance on B, the mole balance on C, and then this is how initial conditions are indicated in polymath, that the number of moles of A with zero in parentheses, meaning at, in this case, time equals zero, the number of moles is 500. Also have a differential equation for the volume changing. Now I have the rate of reaction expression. And this tells me in polymath at what time I'm going to start the integration. I'm going to start at zero, my initial integration time is zero, and I'm going to stop at 120 minutes. Next, I have the differential equation for the energy balance that's explained in the part one of this screencast series. And again, the initial condition, what's the temperature in reactor in Kelvin at the start? And then I list the parameters. The order of this doesn't matter, but it seems easier to be organized, put the parameters together. So I've listed the various parameters and put some comments. And then the other important equation is, it's a semi-batch reactor where we're adding B, but we're only adding B for 50 minutes. So the flow rate of B in the reactor in this command says, if time is less than 50 minutes, then the flow rate is 10 moles per minute. Otherwise, it's zero. So that means once it gets above 50 minutes, the term in the differential equation, this term will go to zero above 50 minutes. And then I have to, of course, define the concentration of A, where both the number of moles of A and the volume are changing as a function of time. And then I asked polymath to calculate conversion in case I want to see what the numerical value of the conversion is as a function of time. And so when I hit the solve button, it'll generate solution. Now this is plotting it. It decides what values to pick for the scales, and it's plotting everything together. I showed a better graph in part one, but what you can see that the number of moles of A decreases. The number of moles of B goes through a maximum. The temperature accelerates. So the temperature starts at 300. The volume, of course, increases linearly with time. And again, going to the first screencast, you can look at better presentation of this output for the semi-batch reactor.